welcome back to Skinny Sports Bar and Grill for the RoadRunners Coaches Show. Come on. NAHL here at Skinny's with us tonight. Of course, we've got the head coach, Josh Kamrass, and we're going to be interviewing later, as well as Andrew Hart, the player for the month of January, as determined by Guns by Design. Always glad to have these guys in, but let's get to some business first. Stuff you all must know. First of all, the voice of the Roadrunners, Art Checker, is unfortunately here, off tonight. Instead, you get the voice of the Roadrunner games, Chris Engesser. Yeah, really nothing. I got nothing for it. All right, next week I'll work on an even better intro, although I think Roach will be back. Let's get to the business at hand. First off, the Roadrunners are heading to Wichita Falls this weekend. We will return next weekend to Landon Arena on April Fool's Day, the final home series of the regular season. Now, on the 2nd, that's the big one. That's where we're giving away that free 2007 Ford Focus you guys got to see last Friday. So make sure you go to Auto Acceptance Center. Between now and then, the end of registration is Friday night. So make sure you get your registration forms in. You can be driving away in that Ford Focus. We also have the $10,000 home remodel shot on the ice. That's my man over there, Keith. He's very excited about that. Now, you're going to be out on the ice with three other contestants trying to make the puck into what is going to be a very small hole in the net. The person that does that is going to walk away with $10,000, hit up Furniture Mall of Kansas, as well as Garner Roofing and Garner Remodeling to register between now and next Friday. RoadRunners Booster Club, everybody give Maria a big round of applause here, is selling tickets for the RoadRunner Chili Cookoff, taking place at Crescent United Methodist Church on March 28th. Yeah. Excellent color right there. All right. And the Roadrunners End of the Year Banquet, also they're selling tickets for, which takes place on April 11th at the Prairie View Golf Club. For more information on how to get tickets, make sure you're at the game, the Booster Club table, up at the top of the section 103 on the 1st and 2nd. You can buy the tickets there, or you can talk to Marie after the show and make that happen. Now, finally, the deadline to lock in a low price for your 2016-2017 season tickets is April 10th. Make sure you get in at least a deposit before the early bird discount expires. And don't forget, the kids under 12 can get free season tickets for the upcoming season. Call 785-286-PUCK. That's 785-286-7825 for more information. All right, folks, again, before we get started, I just want to remind you guys, have some questions ready at the end of the show. We're going to do our fan question extravaganza. You get to ask Coach or Andrew whatever questions just pop in your mind over the course of the show. So without further ado, let's bring on head coach Josh Kamrass. How you doing?
I'm doing great. Not too bad.
All right, Coach. Well, obviously a good weekend that we just had, but we haven't been back here for a couple of weeks. So we also need to talk a little bit about that Amarillo series. Nice sweep on the road, and I'm sure everybody's happy about that. It also concluded on a high note, that 7 week long, break from having home ice at Landon Arena. You hit up Amarillo, they had their backs against the wall. They were, trying to at least stay in the playoff conversation. You went in there and you swept them out. Now, what was the biggest reason the Runners were able to skate out of that weekend with a sweep?
We played good hockey. We went down there, we were off for a little bit, and we had a little bit of rust at the beginning, but we battled through it. And when a team has their back against the wall like Amarillo did, and they're fighting to stay in the playoff, whether it's a slim chance or not, they played really hard. So our guys responded well Friday night, and coming out Saturday, we played a really, really good hockey game Saturday. So we came into this weekend hoping to build off that, and I think Friday night our team did an exceptional job of that. Offensively, defensively, we struggled at times, and we knew where we were deficient, and we talked about it on Saturday, and again on Sunday. That Odessa team, they can skate, and they make some really good plays, and they attack really fast. So I think that was a different kind of game for us this weekend than we saw in Amarillo. So it kind of caught us off guard, it seemed.
Now that Friday night, going back to Amarillo, Lucas scored that game-winning goal with like 5 seconds left, a little under. Capped off an impressive shift as he helped break up the Bulls' rush scoring chance just a moment before, and then he scored the game winner. Talk a little bit about that sequence, if you could, and also about the growth and improvement that you've seen from Luka this season.
That was a big play at a big time in the game. Obviously, with 4 seconds left, getting a breakaway goal, you don't see that too often. And there's a lot of pressure on you as a player going down in that situation. So to see him have the composure and score the goal that he scored, I think it says a lot about where he's at in his development. That takes a lot of composure, a lot of strength to pick that puck off the guy and to go in and put it, on his back end and under the bar. That was a great play by Luke, and he's been progressing very, very good for us. For 2 years now. Last year he came in as a really young kid, the youngest guy on the team. This year he's still one of the youngest kids on the team, still in high school, and you saw about January his game really pick up, and he's been a great player for us. He's getting stronger, he's getting bigger, and when you put those two together with his intelligence and awareness on the ice, I think he's going to be a really good player down the road.
Absolutely. And of course, if you guys are at the arena this weekend, it strikes me just as you say that. I call his name a lot when it came to assists, scoring goals. He has definitely been picking it up here late. Coming home with those pair of wins, after that huge layoff, you finally got ice at home. For practical purposes, you're going into another series, like you say, with Odessa, that they're in playoff mode already. They're trying to battle it out for that fourth spot. Now, let's start off with the Friday game. You said it was an emotional game. It was a very back-and-forth game, but it was also PM Strong's final game. It was a wild 7-6 win, couple lead changes, momentum swings. There seemed to be a sense of urgency to win it for Cam. What was being said on the bench?
Business as usual. Obviously, it's tough for Cam, it being his last game on Friday. And it's in the back of everyone's mind. You could tell before the game that everyone wanted to win so bad. And I think that was a big part of why they wanted to win. Obviously, every time you lace up the skates, you want to win. But I think there was a little bit added incentive for the team. So, for Cam's time here, I couldn't think of a better last shift. He was a mess. He was battling. Like, if there's one guy that you noticed on the ice in the last 40 seconds of the game on Friday, it was Cam. He went out to the point, blocked a shot, lost a stick, came to the bench, grabbed a stick, broke up a play, won a battle on the wall, chipped it out. And that just encompasses Cam's time here. The little things. It's not the flashiest. It's not the goals under the bar. It's the little things that he did. So, that last shift for Cam was, you couldn't have written it any better. For having guys like Cam, that's what it's all about for us. And, we want more kids like Cam. We have 23 of them now. We want even more, next year. And that's something that we try to do in recruiting. So we're really happy that Cam's been a Roadrunner for 2 years. And we're just extremely blessed to have players like that in our locker room.
Absolutely. Kind of in the midst of all that, you speak like a player like Cam. Tyler Hayes in his 100th game as a Roadrunner that very same night. Kind of got lost in the shuffle a little bit. Tell us a little about what Hazy is kind of bringing to the table.
Hazy brings a unique style of defense. He loves to get up and go, and sometimes he gets himself in a little bit of trouble when he does, but when he's able to pull off some rushes and he gets up to speed, he can skate with anyone in this league. So to have that on the blue line is special, and sometimes he'll be on the highlight reel for some of the moves he can put on. But our thing with Tyler is keep it simple and you'll be effective, and he's worked extremely hard on that this year. And it's tough when you have time off like we did to keep the guys be honest with, to stay within themselves and how they play. He went up to the Top Prospects Tournament and did phenomenal. Got a lot of attention up there. And, then we have time off and it's easy to get away from your game. It's easy to forget, our different systems that we have. It's too easy to forget sometimes. So, I think this weekend we saw our guys, we brought our systems, we brought our effort, we scored a lot of goals. Our focus now is preventing those scoring chances, and I don't think it was a bad weekend. Obviously, we let in more goals than we would have liked to, but our systems now are to start shutting teams down. And Odessa's in playoff mode, so That was a good test for us as well.
Yeah. And at the end of the day, it doesn't matter how many goals you allow, so you can win.
As long as you score more. You know, we tried to take the positive out of that. We scored more than they did. And we had like 16 goals, I think, on the weekend.
Yeah, total.
So 16 goals in three games is tough to do. So, you know, we'll try to take the positive out of that. That's tough to do.
Absolutely. Of course, Saturday was kind of a game of weird bounces, you know, and even the game winner, you know, was made possible when the puck just bounced over a defenseman's stick, you know, falling into that breakaway. Looking back, what stands out to you most about that game?
The bounce over the stick.
That's it, pretty much.
No, we came out really, really hard in the third. We, you know, we played good hockey in the third period. And
tied it up.
It's so tough to see when your guys battle so hard. And just a bounce. I, you know, I watched the puck the whole time it was coming, though, and it was on the ice the whole time. And right when Sean went to go play it, it bounced right over his stick. And you know, you can't get mad at that. That's the game. That's the game. That's part of hockey, and you know, that's part of the message that we've tried to help these guys with understand. You know what? It's a game of bounces. You're gonna make mistakes. You know, we gotta come back tomorrow night and make sure. When we have opportunities, we vary our opportunities so that if we do have a bad bounce like this, it's not going to cost us the game. Right. And, you know, we did. We bounced back. Like the way our guys responded to the loss on Saturday. And you know what? You're going to lose games. No one's perfect. You're going to lose games. It's all about how you respond.
And from an MC's perspective, you know, I don't get to focus on the entire game, but I'm watching it Sunday. You can tell that there was a bit of the strain of the three-game weekend playing on both teams. But when we took that 4-2 lead, it was like you just saw Odessa visibly deflate.
Yep.
I mean, that was just pretty much game over at that point, right?
Yeah, and hats off to our guys. They, you know, we came out flat, had a tough first period, and, you know, our guys responded for 40 minutes of that game. They played good, solid RoadRunner hockey. They were finishing their heads. They were making plays, putting the pucks in the net. You know, you're working in units of five, like we talk about in practice. And you know, when we do that, it's tough for teams because we can skate really well. And you know, we have a lot of kids who they have really high playmaking ability and capability. So you know, that when we do that, you know, we'll end up with results like we had on Sunday.
Very true. Of course, the big result from Sunday was locking in third place for the playoffs. So we are guaranteed that we're going to be in the playoffs in the third spot. Let's give the boys a round of applause. Every single year we've been at Topeka, we have had postseason hockey here. With only 3 weeks now remaining in the regular season, knowing that you're locked in the third, though, does that remove any pressure over the last six games? You know, maybe it allows you to use those games to evaluate affiliate players or, you know, do other things that you might not be able to do if you really had to worry about what was going to be, you know, what was on the line.
No, you know, we're not set on the ground. We're not taking it easy. We're keeping our foot on the gas because we want to be on all cylinders once we get into the playoffs. So. And you know what? We got Wichita Falls, who top in our division,
sure,
can be in the playoffs. We have one more series against Lone Star. You know, the final weekend. That's a playoff series that probably we'll face in the first round. So you know what? We can't take any weekends off from here on out because you know we got to be in playoff mode. And just because we've secured the spot doesn't mean. You know, we're guaranteed anything in the playoffs, so we want to be on full cylinders, you know, and the top of our game by the time we hit that first series in the playoffs.
Absolutely. Well, speaking of hitting it at full gears, you know, tonight's player's guest is Andrew Hart. From a coach's perspective, tell us why you love to have a guy like Hart on the ice.
Yeah, it's funny that Andrew is the player doing the interview because on the bench on Saturday, maybe it was Sunday, the bench on Sunday, Joe and myself turned to each other, and even Bob Pope was standing there, and we just said, you know, he's a heck of a hockey player. You know, he makes really, really good hockey plays. You know, he's got a great stick, he's very, very smart, and he works extremely hard. And, you know, when you see a player like Andrew who comes in and he struggled at the beginning of the year a little bit, and it was tough, you know, trying to find a role and fitting in with the new group. It was tough at first, and it's tough for most first-year guys when they come in. But, you know, he's done a great job this year, and he's really, really stepped his game up since Christmas. And I think he was over a point a game in February, and or January it might have been when he got the watch for Player of the Month. But he's just really stepped his game up, and it's at a whole new level that something our scouts saw last year, and he's done a great job. You attribute that to his work ethic on and off the ice, and he cares and he wants to be better every day. And he's got a skill set for this year. He's done a great job, and for next year, the sky's the limit for him.
Well, excellent. Well, hey, Coach, thank you very much. Do you want to stick around and talk to Andrew for a couple minutes?
Why not?
Want me to warm him up for you?
It's up to you. You're the MC. I'm just here.
Andrew, come on up. Andrew Hart, everybody. Interesting, you guys have been really busy in the community today. Did you have any events that you ended up working? Or?
I actually got out of late skate.
Anytime we can help here at the Coaches Show. All right, so like Coach was saying, you're the first year Roadrunner. Like I was saying, the newly minted Player of the Month for January. How did you get started in hockey? What put you on your path to the NA?
Growing up, my uncle played hockey, and I wanted to play hockey too. So when I was around 2 years old, I started skating, and then just continued hockey from there.
Cool. What would you say is the strongest part of your game right now?
I'd say my speed. I like to use that. That's my strongest part.
Do you have like a particular line that you like working on? A couple of guys that you feel kind of really compliment your game and you compliment their game.
I like playing with Q. Mm-hmm. And I played with him a bunch this year, starting out at the beginning of the year, and now I'm playing with him now. And Johnny Walker, he's on my line now, and he's a great player.
No, it seems to work out pretty well this weekend too. Both with you and Quinn. Talk about this upcoming Wichita Falls series. You've played them a number of times already. And of course, just a couple weeks back, a very difficult series, but a close series. But what kind of challenges does that team present, for the Roadrunners in terms of matchups?
I think we're both skilled teams, and they're fast, and we're fast too, so it's always a good series against them.
Mm-hmm. Is there a player that you tried to emulate growing up, that professional player that you want your game to be just like? Is there a guy that you kind of see like that?
Growing up, Mike Richards is my favorite player. He was a hard worker.
Yeah. Good, I got you. Now, after Topeka, man, where do you see yourself next? What's the next step in the progression for Andrew Hart?
College is the goal.
So. Do you have one in mind that you're thinking about? Or a few that you're looking at? Is it like too far out? Or
East Coast, hopefully. East Coast. Stay near home.
Gotcha. No doubt. Well, let's bring on the coach. Get grilled by Coach Kamrass here. Now, remember, you got to say nothing but nice things.
Hello? Okay. Can you hear me okay?
Yeah.
Right. Did you finish all your questions on the list, Chris?
Yes.
Oh, you did. So I'm just winging it here. That's great. Thanks. Andrew, talk about your time here in Topeka. Tell the fans what you enjoy doing with your off time, hobbies that you may have, little things that you do with the guys, pregame routine, stuff like that. Tell the fans kind of what you're all about here in Topeka.
Hobbies are, I like to golf, pick that up this summer, and it's a lot of golf courses here, so I like to go with some of the guys. After practice, me and Hiko usually go and work out together every day. I like to do that. Usually get lunch every day with the guys.
Where do you go?
Chipotle, Chick-fil-A, Cuba. Things like that.
You guys know Chipotle had that food crisis, right?
Yeah.
Okay, as your coach, it's my duty to make sure you're aware of that.
Yeah, we know.
Okay, just be careful when you eat there. We need all our guys healthy. Getting close to playoff time. No, don't need that Chipotle salmonella. Tell E. coli. Is it E. coli? Okay.
Yeah, all right.
Well, they're both bad.
Yeah.
Tell the fans, what's a pregame ritual you have, if you have any?
Pre-game ritual, take a nice nap before the game, and I don't really do anything too much. Usually just tie my right skate first, I don't know why.
You do dress right to left?
Yep.
You do? Okay, that's pretty common.
Yeah.
You know, left to right or right to left. What, you know, the guys give you a hard time every once in a while. What's the word that you say funny that the fans may not know? It's part of your accent being from Pennsylvania. What is there anything that you drink that the boys give you a hard time for?
Water.
Water.
It's water.
Water.
Water. It's that Pennsylvania accent that
Philadelphia
he has.
Philadelphia accent.
Yeah, the Philly accent that they have. They call it water. So, heard the guys get chirping him a little bit today. So, have you enjoyed your time here in Topeka? Has it been positive? Everything's been good for you so far?
Yeah, it's been a lot of fun so far.
Good. And I know you have a great billet family. You really enjoy your time there. Chris asked you a little bit about your plans after. Any school in particular that you've grown up liking? Any teams, NHL, anything like that, that when you were a young kid, you were like, I want to play there one day?
NHL team, Philadelphia Flyers, always been my favorite. Growing up, college-wise, I liked the Boston schools, and now I like Penn State, now that they're Division I team.
Yeah.
So,
yeah.
I like the East Coast. So.
The East Coast life?
Yeah.
You miss it? This is not the East Coast life out here in Topeka, Kansas. I will say, I lived in the East Coast for 4 years. I would much prefer this life, the nice Midwest, slow it down, you know, nice pace out here.
Yeah.
It's always go, go, go out there.
This is true.
Yeah, and how are the drivers in Pennsylvania? Are they aggressive? Do they run you off the road?
No, that's New York and New Jersey.
Yeah, I live in Boston. That's Boston, too. So, you know, I know that you've done, I talked about earlier how well you've done this year. Do you feel that your game has improved throughout the season? And in what areas do you think that it has improved, and where do you think you can improve?
Yeah, I definitely think it improved, especially with my confidence with the puck. I feel like I used to just get rid of it right away at the beginning of the season. Felt obligated to pass it right away, but I feel like I've been holding on to it more and making more plays. Still think I need to shoot the puck more. It's an area I can improve.
Yeah, I would agree. You're out of time this weekend. We talked on the bench.
Yeah.
We should have ferried it.
Mm-hmm.
So your roommate is Yuhiko Saka, who's from Japan. I know he speaks pretty good English. Have there been any language barriers? Have you learned some Japanese since you've lived with him?
No, he hasn't taught me any Japanese yet.
Okay. Anything fun you guys do together? Different culture, so you know you're exposing him to something different, and you're exposed to something different. So how's that been?
He's been great as a roommate. It's really not many barriers, I would say.
Does he make any Japanese food for you? Anything special?
He's made can't think of what it was, but I didn't think it.
You didn't. You didn't like it?
No.
Well, Andrew, thanks for coming here today. You've done a great job this year as a roadrunner. You definitely you do everything the right way. You represent the organization well, and you know, we'll work on more interviews you get. We'll make sure we get you in more. So we'll get that, you know, you'll be cracking jokes here pretty soon. showing the fans the real Andrew Hart. I know when you put the microphone on, it gets kind of intimidating, but,
yeah,
you know, the fans would love to see that personality come out. So thanks for coming here today. And, I think we'll open it up to questions if we have any.
Any kind of questions?
I've got one for Coach. So you were a roadrunner for a long time, and you coached as a roadrunner for a long time. How much of your college career goes into your coaching style?
You know, that's a good question. College is it's a bit of a different game. And unfortunately, my college career was a unique one. I was in Wisconsin my first year, and it wasn't the right situation for me. So I ended up moving to Boston, and I was hurt for most of my career. So it was really tough, and I think that, I think it's helped me today in the sense that, you know what, there's going to be some tough times, and not everything goes the way you want it to, and you gotta stay positive through everything, because everyone else sees, you know, how your attitude is, your mood. They feed off of that, and you know, as a player in college, when you're not playing, you're frustrated. So if you let those emotions creep into the locker room, it's negative energy, and the guys will feed off that negatively. So I think the one area that's helped me the most is learning to stay positive, because I tell you, it was a tough 3 years in college, wanting to play as a 22, 23-year-old, not being able to because of injury. So I think that's the one way that college helped me the most.
Thank you.
Another question for Coach.
How do you decide on the starting lineup?
Well, you know, that's starting lineup is, you know, to me, starting lineup in hockey is, I don't believe in, you know, matchups early on. You know, I think it's good for guys to get everyone to get on the ice early so they can get a feel for it. But starting lineups, I don't view as important as, you know, say basketball, because, you know, they're going to spend 25, 30 seconds on the ice and get off. You just hope the group that you put out there is going to bring the most energy. And that's what we try to do. You know, we don't really match up too much, but we try to put the guys who we feel in practice, you know, throughout the week have had the most energy, and will bring the best, you know, positive energy that first shift.
Who's going to sweep the runway now?
Sweep the runway?
Yeah.
What runway?
Well, Cam does it, sweeps the hallway.
Oh, is that, that's a Cam thing? Someone's going to have to step up?
Yep.
We, you know, not having Cam around, there's a lot of things that Cam does. You know, Cam's still around, I shouldn't say, not having Cam around. Not having Cam play, and we talked about it Friday night with the group, there's a hole to fill. And, you know, that's an opportunity for the next guy in line, and that's how sports are. And someone needs to step up and, you know, take the bull by the horn, so to speak, and run with it. And, you know, that's where we're hoping that everyone steps their game up to try to fill that role, because if we do, we'll be dangerous. But I didn't know he swept around the hallway.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, guys.
All right. Thank you.